What's up, YouTube?
Oh, yes. Yeah, that's good. What's up, YouTube? So, hello. I did a video on a new film coming out called The Lady of Heaven, which appears to be and apparently is the story of the beginning of Islam. And it's a sort of, it's sort of about how the faith was taken over by men. It looks like, well, it would be men really in those days, 1400 years ago, who sort of perverted it and made it into a religion of violence when it was never meant to be that. Anyway, there you go. I haven't seen it yet. I don't think it's out yet. So I thought it'd be interesting, now that I've done Islam, I could do Christianity. So there's a film, it's not a new film, so it's not quite the same, and I have seen it actually, but I thought I'd react to the trailer just to see what I have to say about this, what it makes me feel, and yeah, so let's literally dive right in to the Passion of the Christ. Good catch. Okay, there it is. So as I say, I have seen this film. All the characters speak Aramaic, which I guess makes it more believable and authentic. Of course, what it shows is Jesus's last few days, and interesting that they show all the bits of Jesus being scourged there in black and white, because frankly the amount of blood and gore is utterly shocking. Funny, really ironic, isn't it, that the Lady of Heaven appears to be a very uplifting and sort of, well, a heavenly sort of vision of religion, whereas this film is a sort of brutal horrible, disgusting, violent sort of vision. Of course, you know, pretty accurately taken from the Bible, so it's not as if the film is portraying anything that any Christian wasn't aware of already. I think we see the, you know, we see this, the Gethsemane, Garden of Gethsemane, and is it Peter gets his ear cut off, I think. And what else do we see here? We see Pilate and all that. And of course, the main part of the film for the last, I don't know how long, but it's probably almost like the last third of the film or the last quarter of the film is Jesus being whipped and having the crown of thorns put on, and there's blood everywhere, and it's absolutely traumatic to watch. Torture porn, in a way. I mean, it outstrips anything in Hostel or the Texas Chainsaw Massacre, I'll tell you that much. So it's interesting, isn't it? Christianity is so bloody, and you know, the central sort of theme of it is absolutely repellent. And I mean, really, as an atheist, I have to say that it pretty much sums up why I don't believe in Christianity anymore. I was a Christian for many years, and I gave up when I was about 28, 29, so about 20 years of being a Christian. And I mean, the central thing for me, I stopped believing that Jesus rose from the dead. You know, and really, if you don't believe that anymore, then there's not much point calling yourself a Christian, because otherwise it's just a story then about a man who said he was the Son of God. And whether Jesus even existed is in question, really. So there you go. It's brutal, it's barbaric. It says it's a story of love and grace. But is it? You know, it's funny. I remember as a Christian sitting in church week after week after week, and I went to a few different churches, but the main church I went to in my sort of childhood and early teens was a very Pentecostal, hand waving, shine Jesus shine type of church. Every week was a sort of, oh, Jesus had the nails put through his hands and the nails put through his feet, and he suffered and he bled, and he was in agony, and it was terrible. Let's all sit here now and imagine the terrible agony of the cross. Strange, isn't it? Because you grow up with that, it just seems normal. But what you're doing is going with a group of people and remembering a horrible execution every week on a Sunday, and that's meant to make you feel better. I've got much more to say. I'm not going to get into a huge sort of diatribe about why I don't believe in Christianity. As I said in the other video, I could probably talk for hours about that. I suppose the main thing I would say, and I think this is hopefully interesting because it's something that a lot of famous atheists, you know, Richard Dawkins and Christopher Hitchens and that, those sort of people, don't often mention this, but one of my biggest reservations about religion in general, not just Christianity, is that you're basically told that you're nothing, and you have to trust in God for everything, and you're shit, basically. You're sinful, you're shit, you're nothing, you can never do anything without God allowing you to do it or helping you to do it. And I think that's a really bad state of mind to be in. And the other thing I would say, having been a Christian, is it doesn't it didn't bring me any solace, hope. When I was very young, I think I used to think about heaven and think, oh, won't it be lovely? But as I got older, what I was left with, and I think this is the same for a lot of Christians, is endless guilt. I shouldn't sin, but I do sin, but I'm forgiven. But I still shouldn't sin. Oh, I have sinned. Now I've got to apologize for sinning, and now I'll be forgiven again. And I'll try not to sin again. Oh, but I've sinned again. And it just goes round and round and round. You sin, you apologize, you ask for forgiveness, you sin again, you end up, I think many people end up sort of hating themselves, which is not a great state of mind to be in. As an atheist, obviously, I don't know what's going to happen when I die. There might be a heaven. I'm not saying there isn't. I'm just saying I don't believe that's very likely. But I'm far happier because I decide to believe in the things that make sense to me rather than having to believe what I'm told. And I think that is a far healthier way to live. So that's my my take on that. And next, I'm going to do a reaction to The Passion of the Christ 2. Could anyone believe that film would be made? It's not as ridiculous as it sounds, though it is ridiculous, obviously. As an atheist, it's all ridiculous. So, thank you, and don't nobody go nowhere.